Thank you. Their dress marks them as alchemists. I see no evidence of injury or poison.
Thinkest thou they but slumber?
I believe so. Whether it is by choice is another question entirely.
Oh, we have guests. You must excuse the poor welcome. Long days and longer nights have taken their toll, as you can see. I am Vashan, servant to the satrap. My task was, in fact, to wake these good men and women, if you will allow. People of the great work, I come bearing new scales.
scales? We have new scales?
Yes, my friends. Gather round. I have them right here.
Oh, happy day. Now I can continue my experiment.
Many thanks.
One for me.
Those are dragon scales.
Yes, such materials are vital to their most pressing research.
And we are fortunate to have them. Our experiments are so close to bearing fruit. Soon we will have a talisman capable of nullifying the etheric emissions from that accursed tower. Did I say something wrong? Are you not here with Varshan? Wait, who are you people? Of course! You're the one Cryo sent. The warrior of light we've been waiting for.
Oh, this is a day of celebration. Praise be to Cinderuva!
The winds have shifted. I feel it. The end to our toil is near.
I feel it too. My head hasn't been this clear in days.
Tell me, how did you acquire those scales?
Curious that it concerns you so. But worry not. They were freely given by the dragon with whom our satrap has forged a lawful pact.
That is well.
You must be quite familiar with Dragon King, yes?
Is this their congealed blood I see on your weapon?
Speaking of dragon blood, you yourself have been infused with it, have you not? I should like to draw a file or two, if so.
See here.
Come along, come along. I must insist that you visit our laboratory.
Cease your shoving, or so help me.
Oh dear, your poor companion. What with the new scales and your timely arrival, my colleagues are a little giddy with excitement. No harm will come to him, I promise. Meanwhile, shall we find a quiet place to talk? As you may have guessed, I am Nidana, the alchemist who sent the request to your mistress Cryo. We have workshops across the nation collaborating on this research project. But it is here, at the Great Work, where I collate our results. Come with me, all of you, and I can explain the crux of the situation.
Thank you.
Yes, that would be Razadhan. Hardly anyone has been allowed in or out since our troubles with the tower began. The faithful citizens huddle inside the city walls, and commerce has all but ground to a standstill. I pity the satrap, the trials he must be facing. Completely! Without the satrap and his line, Razadhan would not exist. Long ago, this island was home to two tribes of Matanga, the Gajasura and the Arkasodra. When the Aura came to these shores, it was the Arkasodra with whom they joined forces. Together they defeated the warlike Gajasura, forcing them to flee Thavnair altogether. Peace and prosperity reigned for a time, until a clan of Hjor from the mainland decided they wanted the island for themselves. It was a direct ancestor of the present satrap who arbitrated that conflict and welded the warring factions into the nation we know today. And ever since, a member of that esteemed lineage has inherited this somewhat unique position. You see, by and large, the state is run by the people. But when problems arise, it is the satrap who mediates a solution. The stability provided by the satrap is what has allowed Razadhan to thrive all these years. And it was the satrap himself who entrusted us with this duty. We will not fail him, nor our countrymen.
What is the delay with the vessel? I told you I need to adjust those ratios.
I come all this way to admire one of my splendid towers, and what do I find? Fools. Attempting to ward off its tempering influence with magic trinkets. I seem to recall a similar experiment in ages past. What was that man's name? Oh something? Owee?
Another body, another time. Who could be expected to remember every trivial detail?
Allowing them to construct such handy talismans would be counterproductive to my plans. And yet, I find myself deathly curious. How will they manage this feat with the limited knowledge and resources at their disposal? Complications be damned. For we cannot escape the nature of our souls. And I, as ever, am my own worst enemy.